In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a form for data entry. Now, a lot of companies hold data in databases, and as you can see, I've already input some car details into my car table for my database. But companies and software normally won't allow you to see the tables that store the data. And what you'll normally find is that data is input via a mask or a form that sits on top or over the tables. Now, whenever you sign up for a Hotmail or a Gmail account, you've probably filled in a form with your name, your personal details, phone number, so on, and created an email account. That data is stored in a table, but you've never ever seen that table. You've only ever seen the form. And that's what we're going to do here, is create a form to input data in a more user-friendly fashion. Now, there are a couple of ways of doing this. The first way is to let Access do it for you, which is quick, but it's a bit ugly. I'll show you that. And the other way is for you to create a form yourself from scratch. Now, I prefer the second method because you've got a bit more control over what goes in, where it goes, and so on. So, as I said, there's a number of different ways of doing it. I'll show you three different ways. Now, in this instance, there's only one table. So Access will, in the first method I show you, will just grab the data from the table and create a form. Then I'll show you to design a form, and then I'll show you to use the form wizard. But my preferred method is the second one. You actually design the form yourself. So, how to create a form? Well, you go to create, and the simplest way of doing it, click on form. And what that'll do in this instance, it'll grab that data from that table, create a form over the top, and as you can see all the data, but you can only see the data for one record. Now, if I show you the table, that's one record there. That's also a record there. And in the form, you can only see one record on the screen at any one time. You've got to use these buttons here to move through them. Now, as I said, I don't really like that method. You've got no control over the width of the boxes, the font. You can mess around with it later, but it's not my preferred method. So no to save changes. I'll show the second method I'm going to show you now. I'm going to jump around a bit, and I'm going to show you how to use the form wizard. Again, the result is very much the same. You go to form wizard, and it tells you the table you're going to choose from. Now, at the moment, there's only one table. If you had multiple tables or queries, you'd be able to choose different ones from up here. So I'm only going to use the car stock table because that's the only table I've got. And what you can do here is add all the fields or just add some of them. Say no, you didn't want staff to type in the price. You could take the price out and only type in, allow them to type in other things. So take the price out. But in this case, I'm just going to add them all. Go to next. You can choose different formats. Personally, I just go for the columnar one. But you have got other options there. Go to next. Now, the title I want for this, I don't want to call it T because it's not a table, it's a form. So I call it F car stock. And go to finish. And what that'll do, exactly like last time, it's created a form. But again, you had a bit more control over what went in, what didn't go in. As I said, that's not my favorite method, so I'm going to close that down now, and I'm also going to go to forms, and I'm going to delete that form from there because I don't want it. You saw what I did there. I clicked on this little drop down, and I just chose forms. I could just do all Access objects and that'll show everything I've got, so I'll just delete that from there. Delete, that's right click delete. Now, the third method, my preferred method, is creating the form myself. So I go to create, form design, and now you've got to add the fields. And to do that, you click on add existing fields up here. And what that'll do is it'll bring up a field list, and you can go to show all tables. Click on that, and you'll see your table there, table car stock. Click on the little plus sign there, and you can either add these individually by clicking and dragging over, as I'm doing now. If you don't want them, click back on them on the form here. Or if you want to choose them all, select the first one, hold shift down, select the last one, and then click and drag them off on mass, as it were. Now, once you've dragged them over, undo, you can then tweak where they go on the screen. You can also change the size of the input boxes. And what you'll end up with is a far more compact form than you would with the wizard methods. And when you finish that, all you need to do is close the form down, save it, yes. Now we'll call that form car stock and click on OK. Now what we've got now is a form that holds all the data, and as before we can scroll through it, but you've got the added satisfaction of knowing that you've designed this yourself and you know how the form works. Now what we're going to go on to do next is make the form a lot more, well, a lot prettier, and add some functionality in terms of buttons, so you haven't got to rely on these silly little buttons down here instead. Okay, that's it, we're done on a basic form.